pathetic planet from the face of the galaxy.
The Force fights with me!
Get on those gun turrets!
You made it. Several Jedi have already gone ahead into the Starforge. We have to strike while we still have the element of surprise. If we don't stop Bastila from using her battle meditation, the entire Republic fleet will be wiped out! Come on, before they... Damn! So much for catching them unprepared. We'll deal with these Sith. You get into the Starforge and find Bastila. Hurry!
Lord Malak, a team of Jedi have penetrated our defenses. Their fighters have landed on the Starforge.
This is not unexpected. The Jedi are formidable opponents. Send the Starforge's battle droids to deal with them.
Lord Malak, forgive me, but how can mere droids be a match for the Jedi?
You underestimate the power of the Starforge's droid army. Dispatch the droids.
Of course, Lord Malak. The Jedi have invaded the Starforge. Destroy them. Destroy them all.
Hey guys, happy New Year's. It's 2023 and I hope y'all enjoying your day, because I'm gonna say it's a whole new year. Damn. I'm gonna say we are about to beat Read about the big song with the Knight of the Republic. If y'all wondering if I'm gonna play as the evil version, I mean the dark side enemy, one day. But right now I wanna play this game, and I might head back onto the PlayStation. You know, to see some other games is on there. But also, I just want to. But I also want to say that I got Knight of the Republic 3. If y'all want me to play a sequel of this game, and like I said, to those who never played this game, Knight of the Republic is one of the best games that was ever created. When this came out, like, I don't know, 2003, I think. This game was very fun. And Knight of the Republic 2 is much more, is improved everything from the first one.
Ah, more victims for us to slaughter.
Yeah, I'm not gonna be able to defeat me. They really think they're gonna beat us. My team is strong and weapon maybe was oh my god. I say, hell, which way we are going? That too. Okay. We gotta find Bessela in this damn place. And Revan. I mean, Malik.
Why have you disturbed me?
I have news, Lord Malik, about the Jedi.
Ah, the Jedi. Did my droids pass their test? Did they destroy our enemies?
No, Lord Malik. The droids could not stop them.
Strange. I did not think there were any among the Order who could survive an attack by an army of the Starforge's battle droids.
It was Revan, Lord Malik. Your old master is with the Jedi here on the Starforge.
Yes, that would explain why the droids failed. Revan was always strong in the Force. Very well. Send out all available troops, the apprentices as well.
Do you think they can stop Revan, Lord Malik?
Of course not. But they will slow Revan down. That will give me the time I need to fully prepare the Starforge's defenses. I am curious to see the true extent of this space station's capabilities. One as powerful as my old master will make an interesting test subject.
Thank you. What is it? What is it?
And you need?
Yes?
I will be your doom!
Master, why have you summoned me? Without my battle meditation, there is a chance the Republic capital ships could break through and attack the Starforge itself.
This will not take long, Bastila. You will be able to resume your battle meditation soon enough. I only wanted you to know that Revan is here on the Starforge.
Revan? But...
The Force is bringing us towards a confrontation with my old master. The Starforge has drawn our enemies together. You must kill Revan to prove yourself worthy of being my apprentice, Bastila. You must finish what began in the Rakatan.
Yes, Lord Malak.
I sense your fear, Bastila, but it is unfounded. The power of the Starforge will feed the dark side within you. It will give you the strength you need to defeat my old master. Stay here in the command center while you use your battle meditation against the Republic fleet. Revan will find you here.
Of course, Master. I will not fail.
Perhaps you will triumph, Bastila. But even if you fail, it will give me the time I need to complete my preparations of the station's defenses. And then we shall see if Revan can stand against the full fury of the Starforge.
Revan, I knew you'd come for me. You're wasting your time. I've seen the Jedi for what they are, weak and afraid. Now you must pay the price. Here on the Starforge, the power of the dark side is at its strongest. Followed you. even though you're only a shell of your form. I can't even imagine the power you must have wielded when you were the Dark Lord. You were a fool to give it all. The dark side has made me stronger than I ever was before. I have a greater command of the Force than all but the most powerful Jedi. As Malak teaches me the greatest secrets of the Sith, I will unlock more of my potential. Have you forgotten the ways of the Sith already, Revan? Eventually, I will challenge my master. If I am worthy, he will die. Then I will take on my own apprentice, and the cycle will begin again. This is the way of the Sith. No, Revan. It is you who are doomed. You're growing weary. I can sense it. Your strength falters. The light side is failing you while the power... The dark side will always triumph over the light. Malak has assured me of victory. You can't defeat me here on the Starforge. You can't! This is not possible. You have rejected the dark side. You are a weak and pathetic servant of the light. How can you still stand against me? Why can't I defeat you? Yes, I see you speak the truth. I am no match for you. Please, for the sake of what we once shared, do not make me suffer. End my life quickly. There is no other way. What other choice do you have? I have fallen to the dark side. I am the... No. I am not strong enough. There is too much anger inside me. You always had more strength than I did. I told you that. I felt so helpless before. You were Revan and I couldn't tell you. It was agonizing. Even worse when I began to feel closer to you. I despised. And even now, I feel your strength. It does help me. Thank you. You love me. There was a time I yearned for and yet dreaded to hear those words. I loved you. Malak knew how I felt. Any part of the light that was within. But what good is love? It cannot save me from the sea of blackness I am drowning in. I have betrayed everything. Yes, I could join you in your battle against the Dark Lord. That alone would not make up for all I have done. But how would you be able to trust me? How do you know I wouldn't turn on you when you face Darth Malak? How do you know the Dark... You play a dangerous game. Are you certain you wish to take this risk? I could end your life and gain Malak's favor with a single stroke of my lightsaber. You are brave, and some would say foolish. But you are also right. The dark side has not wholly consumed me. I cannot raise my blade against you. You will go on to defeat Malak, and you said you loved me. This may not be the best. I love you too, with all my heart. After this? No. Nothing could make me feel safer than to be loved by you. You should go. Malak awaits. This isn't over yet. For any of us. I should stay here, though. If we face Malak, I am afraid his dark presence will overwhelm me. It would not be wise to expose myself to such temptation. Yes, that would be for the best. You don't need me to defeat Malak anyway. Now I understand that a true Jedi is a match for any Sith. Even the Dark Lord himself. I will stay here in this chamber and use my battle meditation to aid the Republic fleet. I am their only hope of destroying the Starforge and ending the Sith menace. You must go and face Malak, but you have to hurry. Good luck, my love, and may the Force be with you.
There. A break in the Sith formations. Green Squadron, move in.
Green Squadron, moving in. Squadron's through. We've broken their lines. Bastila is no longer using her battle meditation against us. The tide has turned.
Red Squadron, into the breach. Capital ships, reinforce their position.
We save Bastila, now we gotta take down our best friend, our fucking Quintus. Malik. Show off.
I'm tired of this game, Revan. You have been a thorn in my side from the moment I seized the mantle of Dark Lord from your feeble You made a mistake coming here, Revan. The Starforge. Is that what you call it? You think stripping away your power and your identity was an act of mercy, Revan? I would rather die. Spoken like a true slave of the Jedi Code. Save your preaching, Revan. I will have none of it. You are an insignificant speck beneath my notice. I have surpassed you in every way and accomplished what you never could. I have unleashed the full potential of this Rakatan factory. You had no idea of the power within this place. Its very walls are alive with dark side energies. And now, my old master.
You are not gonna be able to defeat me, buddy. Shoot. You was on the mic. You was on the mic too, remember? We were both Jedis. Hell, we were both Jedi. I once took the fight to the damn Mandalorians to you, buddy. If you were the big boss, how come I'm the one did it much better than you? And anyway. Don't have enough. Forget all that and try and get to him. There he is. Save the game. Hey, Malik.
Well done, Revan. I was certain the defenses of the Starforge would destroy you. But I see there is more of your old self in you than I expected. You are stronger than I thought. Stronger than you ever were during your reign as the Dark Lord. I did not think that was possible. I am tempted to try and capture you alive, Revan. Then I could break your will and bind you to me as my apprentice. As I did Bastila. You'll be a far greater asset to me than even Bastila and her battle meditation. If I could control you, perhaps you are too powerful to be my apprentice. I betrayed you when I realized my own strength was greater than yours. In time, you might try to do the same to me. No, Revan. This time our confrontation can only once again. We shall face each other in single combat. Continue to amaze me, Revan. If only you had been the one to uncover the true power of the Starforge, you might have become truly invincible. But you were a fool. All you saw was an enormous factory. All you ever imagined was an infinite fleet rolling forth to crush the Republic. You are blind, Revan. Blind. The Starforge is more than just a space station. In some ways, it is like a living creature. It hungers. Look around you, Revan. See the bodies? You should recognize them from the Academy. These are Jedi who fell when I attacked Dantooine. For all intents and purposes, dead. Except for one difference. I have not let them become one with the Force. Instead, I have brought them here. You cannot beat, and once you are beaten,
sack of shit, trying to disrupt my abilities. That shit. You ain't using them to just as a battle. We gotta put a stop to that shit. I gotta give him one thing, motherfucker is fast. So had become one with the Force. This one's hung out that to Char drain all his life force. So the people I fled from that glass is became their self became one with the Force. That's good. Nice. Okay, but now I need to feed this motherfucker. Stop disrupting my damn abilities, you sack of shit. One more. Alright, motherfucker. Let's go. Disrupting my abilities again? Stop that shit. And fight me. I win. I know that's cheating, but hey. You take any advantage you can get, right? Oh shit. Priceless.
Impossible. I cannot be beaten. I am the Dark Lord of the Sith.
This is the way of the dark side, Malice. All things ends with death. The power of the light will always be stronger than the dark.
Still spouting the wisdom of the Jedi, I see. Maybe there is more truth in their code than I ever believed. I cannot help but wonder, Revan, what would have happened had our positions been reversed? What if fate had decreed I would be captured by the Jedi? Could I return to the light as you did? If you had not led me down the dark path in the first place, what destiny would...
I am sorry I started you on this path, but you choose to continue down it.
I suppose.
Yeah, that's my fault. Because I'm the one made him become like this. And I'm the reason why his mouth is fucked. To those who don't know, why Malak had that thing, why his mouth is gone, is because...
It might have been yours, perhaps.
Because... Malak wants to be number one, and he challenged Revan. Revan was toying with the man, and as a punishment for, stay down and not, divide him, he sliced his fucking mouth. He ain't got no mouth. Which is really fucked up, because holy shit, man. I understand you want your dominance, but you ain't had to slice a motherfucker's mouth open.
There you are. What happened?
There was no way to turn into the light. I had to kill him.
I don't think anyone actually expected that he could be redeemed. I'm surprised you would even think of trying. There's no time to say just yet.
Did you forget I was the Sith Lord? Y'all took my entire Jedi Council to become a good guy. What you talking about? You act like Malak was the worst of the bunch. Did y'all forget y'all sent the whole shebang of Jedi trying to kill me?
Dodonna, we've hit their main orbital stabilizers.
Everyone pull back. I don't want to lose any ships when that space station goes down.
We did it, Vandar. The Sith are routed and the Starforge destroyed.
But at what cost, Admiral? Where is the Ebon Hawk and her crew?
made it.
We couldn't let you start the victory party without us, Admiral.
I'm sending an honor guard to escort you in. You'll be getting a hero's welcome when we all get home.
Mission complete.
You'll have defeated Malak, destroyed the Starforge, and broken the spirit of the Sith. For this, I am proud to present you each with the Cross of Glory, the highest honor the Republic can bestow. From Coruscant to the farthest reaches of the Outer Rims, you will be known as the saviors of the Republic.
On behalf of the Jedi Council, defenders of the galaxy, and sworn protectors of the Republic, I too would like to honor you for your actions. We Jedi now have another tale to weave into the grand history of our eternal order. The redemption of Revan, the prodigal knight. Wherever you go, you will be recognized as the saviors of the galaxy, the heroes of our age. But you must remain ever vigilant, for one day you may be called upon yet again to defend the glory of the Republic against the tyranny of the dark side. For this is the destiny of the Jedi.
And that, my friend, is the end of Star Wars Knight of the Old Republic. Like I said, this game is fucking phenomenal. If you never played this game, I highly recommend this. Because before Jedi the Fallen Order, the fucking Jedi, the Force Unleashed, all that game, Lego, Star Wars, all that shit, play this one, Star Wars Knight of the Old Republic. This was one of the best games that was ever created, and it's so damn awesome. Like I say, it's simple, it's grounded, and more importantly, it's so straightforward to the point to the game that you know what you're doing, you know where to go, and everything. Shoot. I know y'all be like, what about the characters? Sometimes the characters may not be the best or strong suit of character development, but it's still standable. I know people are like, well, this guy is a whip of that one character. Well, technically, you are correct, but that doesn't matter if the game still got good writing, the story is still still superior and still strong written, you know the game is still that damn good. It doesn't matter how much the graphics looks and outdated it looks. The game is still fun. If the story is still entertaining, the combat and everything you play is still fun. I know y'all be like, oh, when you gonna do Star Wars Knight of the Old Republic 2? That, my friends, is gonna be one of these days. But right now, I'm gonna take a break of live streaming and celebrate Happy New Year's. And once again, I wanna say that before, and I will say it again. Happy New Year's to everyone. It's 2023 and New Year and, well, there's so many games that's coming out this month and the next month. And honestly, I can't wait. That's why I'm saying, if I'm gonna play another throwback game on Twitch, it's gonna be one of those days. Right now, I wanna get back to playing some games that came out and, you know, see how they are. Hell, the games I'm thinking about is seeing the new Harry Potter game, Hogwarts, because I'm a huge Harry Potter fan. I'm a huge Harry Potter fan. I love the movies, and more importantly, I love the books much more because I'm a book reader, and I love reading books. I want to give it a chance. And I know y'all be like, is there any other games that you want to try it out? I don't want to give this game a chance, but I'm gonna say it. I might try out Resident Evil 4 Remake. As much I did enjoy the game, but it did not feel like Resident Evil to me. Because look at Resident Evil 3 Remake. That was horrible. I'm sorry, because you can't tell me that was a good game. The writing was as they cut out so much shit from the original game, from the original Resident Evil 3 game, and they did a massive disservice to it. They made Jill very unlikable. Carlos, they gave him a better role, I mean, and much more tolerable of a personality than the original one. I'll give him that much, but it was not a good game. They fucked up so badly. They made, like I said, they made Jill insufferable. So insufferable that this is not the same character I know from the original and Resident Evil 3 original game. Because if you're trying to tell me that it's the same Jill I supposed to know from in the other games, I don't think so. That is not Jill. I'm sorry. She don't even... Oh, fucking hell. And fuck off this SJW... This support I'm trying to appease to the modern audience bullshit. Just fuck off that noise and fuck off. But like I said, I might give Resident Evil 4 a try. If they do a good job with it and actually make it like a Resident Evil game, I will give it the benefit of the doubt. If they fucked up, I'm gonna call it out. And seriously, and I know they're gonna do some adjustment to Ashley's character, because I know people, like, they really do not like how Ashley were in the Resident Evil 4 game, because she was literally like a damsel, and we got to protect her like a heart attack, like that. And I get that, and I understand that, because she is the president's daughter, and more importantly, she's not a fighter, and I understand that. But why do I get the feeling like, in if we see the Resident Evil 4 remake game, they're gonna make her much more than that. I bet they're gonna try to make her like she's a badass and everything, despite she had no combat experience or in anything. She's just a regular innocent girl who's just the person's daughter. Sure, I know you're like, what about the time that you could throw face at people, lamps and people? Dude, the fact that she can use the environment to throw like lamps and shit to do that, I give that a pass. But if they trying to make her do more than something that is not believable, I'm gonna call that out, because it's just that simple. I'm not gonna clap my fucking hands and just bend over to something that is not believable. Because people could do something, and there are some characters they should not do, because like I said, like this. What's the example? shit. There are so many games, and you had no idea. What is a good example? Oh, fuck, I'm tired. You know what? I'm getting tired by yelling and shit. I mean, talking about how, you know, it felt like I'm doing a movie with you. Okay, I'm going to stop right here. Okay, I'm done. But like I said, we're going to put the drawback games, we're going to put that on a hold for a sec. And I'm gonna go back on the PlayStation 5 and, you know, play some games with my friends and see new games that are coming out this month. And I hope y'all stay tuned for the next one when I live stream on my YouTube channel. Like I said, I'm gonna upload all my videos from Knight of the Republic onto my YouTube channel. Please subscribe to my Twitch channel and my YouTube channel. Thank you, and I love y'all, and peace. Thank you. Bye.